What's up, guys? Welcome back. I'm gonna do another QuickFlix. So it's kind of basic. I just want to basically go over some of the stuff that I did related to the oiling on the engine. Oiling for the turbo, return line, block off plate, stuff like that. Show you what I'm doing. On this side of the engine, where the oil cooler port is, I'm using the existing block off plate from the other engine that I had. Basically, this is blocking off the oil cooler passages. I did go ahead and I got different bolts, because this is a kit that I got online, and it came with bolts, but they were Allen head bolts. And when I tried to remove them from the other oil pan, they both stripped out, and I couldn't get them out, so I ended up having to take a grinder, grind the head off, and then pop that plate off of there. So I went and got two new bolts for it. They're M6x1x25 bolts. Those work pretty good. And they shouldn't strip if I ever have to remove them for anything. So now we're back on the other side of the engine. I ended up using a half inch NPT to 5/8 hose barb for my oil return line. I did have a bung welded onto the old pan, but this is where that section broke out. So I did not reuse that, and I don't feel like trying to weld a new one in there. This is my old line here. See, that bung was welded on, and this is like a dash 8 or a dash 10 line, I believe it is, and I'm just going to cut that thing off and put it on the hose barb. Coming around to the backside here, we got this little goofy setup going on. So basically, this is an M16 by 1.5 to a dash 4 fitting, and then this is a dash 4 to a dash 4 coupler, dash 4 female to dash 4 male. It also has an 1/8 inch NPT female end on it, which I'm using, which goes to this oil pressure switch. You can see that oil pressure switch is a 30 PSI oil pressure switch.
I'm not actually going to be running the oil pressure to the computer. The computer doesn't need to see the oil pressure to run, and I'm not going to log it or anything, but I do want to be able to see if I'm losing oil pressure for some reason. So I went ahead and bought that 30 PSI oil pressure switch. So if it drops below 30 PSI, then I'll get my idiot light on the dash, and then I'll know that something's going on. So the whole time I was running before, I wasn't even using anything, so I didn't have any oil reference at all. So this is actually gonna put me in a better spot than I was in before. This truck doesn't have an actual working oil pressure gauge. It's just like a yes or no. So it's kind of like an idiot light. You have it or you don't. But the factory oil pressure switch is only at like 6 or 8 pounds, I think it was. I actually tested it on my compressor, and I think it tripped at like 6 or 8 pounds, somewhere in that range. Basically, that's only gonna show you a near complete loss of oil pressure, and it's not gonna show you anything below 30 PSI, which is why I got that switch. So if I start to get low oil pressure for some reason below 30 PSI, then I'd get my light and I'd know something's probably going on.
So basically then from here, this is also gonna be going to my turbo feed line. So it's just another dash 4 line that's gonna go to my turbo feed.
So that's it for this one, guys. Kind of quick and easy, but I know me personally, I had a lot of questions and spent a lot of time trying to figure out how I wanted to do all this stuff when I was building this. This is where I ended up. This is what I'm doing. Doesn't mean that's what you have to do, but that's what I'm doing. Thought I'd share. Have a good one.